Welcome to the Totally Awesome Fishing Show. We're here at Avington Trout Fishery. We're going to do a stillwater stalking trout video.
Now, some of you out there, probably in foreign countries, think, seems awfully easy, this trout fishing in England. Well, if you live in Montana or New Zealand or South Africa or somewhere in Scotland, in Wales, where you've got wild trout fishing, that's fine. They would generally be smallish fish, but that's fine. They're growing on from an egg and they hatch out there and they live naturally. But the majority of around the British Isles, they don't have that facility. You know, they're under threat from pollution, from cormorants, from all sorts of predation. So what they have is a whole put-and-take fishery. It's called put-and-take. They put the trout into big lakes, even big reservoirs, 400, 500, 600 acre reservoirs. They have to be stocked. The anglers catch them, they take them, knock them on the head, and eat them. That's fine, but you still have to target those trout, don't you?
Yep. So we're going to be using, well, sort of your standard fly gear, really. What, seven, eight weight rods. I think I'm starting on a white chomper fly. What we found with the stillwaters is a lot of the fish here you can get in the margins. They sit in the margins in close. So what we've done as we've come in is we've done a lap of the lake, this first lake here at Avington, just to gauge what the fish are doing. Are they moving fast? Are they moving slow? Are their mouths moving? Are they taking flies? Just little things we're trying to take. Looking over the edge, over the reeds especially, the sort of grass in the banks, there's a good area for them to be in close. And we're just getting a rough idea of where these fish are.
See, what happens here is Avington Fishery is fed by the River Itchen. The River Itchen, for those of you who don't know, is about one of the most famous historical trout stretches of river in the south of England, you know. That is, without doubt, is pure, clean water. So the stock ponds are fed by clean water and the lakes are spring-fed and fed by, you know, fed by the carrier streams as well. So that gives you very, very clear water. It gives us the advantage, really, over the trout, because you can be fly fishing away on a lake or anywhere you like, pulling away, that's great. You can have the best fly in the world, or what you think's the best fly. It makes no difference at all if there ain't no trout in front of you. Now, the advantage in these southern clear waters, you got the advantage of walking around, seeing where what we call the dead spots are, obviously not wasting your time fishing there, so we are not wasting any time casting, blind casting. We do not cast until we spot a trout.
So we're going to give it a go. We're going to try probably this first lake to begin with, purely because we've seen the trout. We know they're here. They are here in the margins, just out in the middle of the lake as well. So we're going to do a bit of stalking, keeping a low profile, not making too much noise. Wind's slightly picking up a bit. It's overcast. It's, you know, it's not ideal conditions for spotting the trout, but luckily, thankfully, the water is really gin clear at Avington. So I think time to get the flies on.
Off here we go.
Do a bit of stalking.
Give it a go. And as I say, we won't cast until we see a fish. We're trying to target slightly bigger fish by this stalking technique. You know, even though we can see fish moving around in the area, we'll give you some more tips on the way as we go. You know, we still want to try and target, what are we going to say, 3 pounds?
Yeah, four pounds. 4 pounds, yeah.
I'm going to set the bar high. We don't want to catch anything less than 5 pounds in weight. See if we can target them. Let's go.
Right, well, we've just barely got, you know, down the lake, and we've spotted a few decent-sized trout, not massive, but decent-sized trout, about a rod length away. Now, what I'm using a standard sort of 9 foot, 7 weight fly rod, trout rod, floating line. I've got 10 foot of leader with the fly I'm using today, at the moment to start with, is the shell, the white chomper, sort of shell matte white chomper, little olive shell back to it there. And all I'm going to do is just almost a rod length out, really flick it out, just the leader, and just jiggle. I'm just going to jiggle the fly up and down, sort of 1 inch movements with the rod tip, and I just want to gauge the reaction of the trout, not necessarily catch them. I just want to gauge the reaction, and if they're not reacting to this fly, maybe I'll change fly or I'll change different depths. So let's give it a go. Now we've got this, well, this awkward sort of overcast, dull cloud, blanket white cloud, which is horrible really for spotting trout. It just, leaves a big white glare on the water, and even with strong Polaroids, you cannot see through the water. So use the vegetation on the opposite side of the bank, overhanging trees, bushes, things like that. They will cast out a shadow over the water and actually allow you to see through the water. They cut out the cloud. So sometimes if you look on the opposite bank and find a big sort of trees, overhanging bushes, use them to your advantage and try and get a trout swimming through that area.
You don't always have to cast a long way when you're looking for these trout. Just make sure your back cast is clear so you don't snag the trees. And with summer like Avington, that clear water gives you the benefit of not wasting any time. You can see there's a couple of trout in this picture. Yes, they're unresponsive to the fly, but that enables you to change fly patterns and actually see which one is it, you know, that they could be interested in. Now that back trout actually turned, whereas the right hand trout has turned away and doesn't like the look of that fly.
Oh, we've got a big one, not even a rod length out. This really is in the margins. He's sitting there, his mouth's moving, so he might be feeding, but he is not moving at all, so he probably could be easily spooked.
For a trout that's very close, you need to keep those arm movements to a minimum and don't, you know, go rushing around between the gaps there that you can see. You just need enough just to drop that fly in front of him and see if you can get any response at all. Now, in summer conditions, which this is, you will often find those trout lying static in the water because there's a lower oxygen content. They don't like it. They like cold water. Cold water gives you a higher oxygen content. They're going to be more active. But hey, we're trout fishermen. We have to make do with the conditions that exist at the time.
Well, guys, I've heard a shout down there. We've obviously got split up yet again. Mike's got the net. Now, we actually got two nets. Now, he's got a fish here. Heard the shout. Let's take a look at it. He's lucked out. Good boy, Mike. Oh, nice fish. Yes, nice fish. And I tell you what, I have to be honest, I was actually jiggling for baby perch and it was real good fun. I've got this little kind of olive mini damsel with a gold bead to it. I was just jiggling for perch. I actually got a small perch on the camera. I thought, oh, this is a good bit of fun. You know, the trout we hit fishing was rock hard, so I was just jiggling away. And then this thing just sat there near my fly. So I picked up and flicked out, literally, I'm talking 5 feet from the bank. Jiggled exactly how I was jiggling for the perch, 1-inch jiggles, literally up and down, 1-inch jiggle, 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 and he absolutely just really slowly came up to it, just snapped it.
So it paid off looking for those shadow lines of the trees, because I left you, you were under those trees, weren't you?
Yeah, and then this horrible ripple came, so I thought, oh, this is going to kill it completely. Wind died off a bit, and that's when I saw this one when the sun came out. So I thought, oh, I'll just chuck it in front of him. It was about a foot in front of his nose that I chucked it, and gave it the famous totally awesome 1-inch jiggle.
And he nailed it.
And he absolutely nailed it. And it's quite a nice looking...
Good fish. It's got to be far off our 5 pound target.
I say at Avington, four. They have a lovely red colour to them here.
Yeah. And you can see on the cheek of that fish, just there, you can see that cheek of the fish.
Yeah,
there.
Really, really
bright colour. So yeah. What fly? That's what we want to know.
Let's have a look. That was this.
We started on the white chomper, nothing.
It's kind of like an olive.
Let's see if we can, get in there.
You see that there? It's got the gold bead to it, which I think really switched the perch on when I was going for it. They absolutely loved that. It's kind of like a small shrimp to them, I guess. Well, big shrimp.
Yeah.
And then it's got this sort of, it's like a damsel, really. It's a small...
sort of gold ribs, hairs here.
Yeah, it's got a bit of weight to it, so it sinks relatively quick.
Well, it did the job, obviously. Yeah, yeah, small fly, though, you see, small fly.
Small fly, yeah.
Well, I've just changed over to that when all else fails. I heard you shout.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go back up the other end of the lake, because I'm going to be using those clumps of grass to stand on. Because the wind's really annoying and rippling.
Yeah, I'm just going to patrol this margin, I think, to be honest, while you're down the other end. I'm just going to go up and down the margin because I've seen one or two fish just cruising up and down. So I might give them the 1-inch jiggle.
Yep.
And see if it pays off.
Okay, I'll go and see if I can catch up with you.
All right.
Well, guys, I came right at the end. As you can hear by the reel, we're hooked up. Mike had one earlier on down there. He told you about how he was like fishing in the shadow line. Actually fishing for perch, I think he was, isn't he?
Yeah, I was jiggling up and down in the margins, messing around with perch. And then a big rainbow came along and just snapped up the fly.
And what fly did he take?
I think mine was sort of an olive damsel with a gold bead to it. They fight fish. Well, mine didn't wake up for ages.
It's a good fish. Bloody hell.
He's taking his time, isn't he?
Yeah, he's been over the back, under the trees. You see the line cutting through the water over there?
Yeah, right
he's
in the overhang.
The surface. He's cutting and cutting through the water. I don't want him in that rough reed on the right. He gets a load of weed on the leader. I'm just coming inside it. Please come this side. Thank you. I'm going to go down this, get an angle on him. Now this one took when all else fails. I've missed two. They are so just nipping at it. I think I just pulled it straight out of their mouth, but we haven't got this one yet. This is a nice fish. This is a nice fish. I want to be able to show this one to you guys. Now, two or three goes out. Let's get the net ready. Now this one, I just stood on a clump of weed, like I mentioned earlier, one of the tips, just to give me an extra bit of visibility looking through the water. And I've come up this end where this strong ripple just come up, an easterly wind, which is never good. Come in. Oh, this is a nice fish. This is a nice fish. And it gave me a bit of an extra vantage height so I could look down through the water. And that enabled me to get cast off the cast in front of his nose. And I just barely just see him. You just see them do something different. You know what it is? A lot of it is, it's a nice fish, here he comes. A lot of it's watching the body language of the fish. That is a nice fish. Oh, nice fish.
So what was the targets we set ourselves at the beginning? You said
it's here. It's
this fish, you reckon?
But we haven't got it yet.
It's been tough.
It's been tough. This is going to do the old £5. I think we might be even pushing £7 with that fish.
That's a chunk, actually, that fish.
That is a chunk. Do you know what? There's another one in here. Will we get back? Are all anglers greedy? And the answer to that is yes. There, you can see, people, when all else fails, when a Sid nights, it's barely nothing. It's just the weighted wire on the hook shank. But I absolutely love to death this sort of tinsel flash stuff. I don't know what they call that. He does an ultraviolet one, but... Man alive, is that where you come to places like Avington for? That is a ka-chunking great big rainbow trout. That has really done us more than £5. I think we might be pushing at £7 there. That's a beauty. Do you know what? That was tough fishing, but it's almost more satisfying when you're up against it, because all anglers like easy fishing, of course we do. But when it's hard, the wind comes up, the light's bad, you get really frustrated. And when you lose two and then you nail one, that's what good fishing is all about. That's the enjoyment.
Well, Dad's just had that chunker of a trout, and there's another one in here. The wind's really picking up, so this ripple is horrible. He's just in here, I can see him. I'm gonna wait and just try and see if I can get him here, but it's so windy. Hopefully he's gonna come out from this bush in a minute. I'm just holding
Fish straight on.
Yeah.
Just straight in. Straight ahead, there he goes.
I know.
Small one, he's going under the bush.
I'm just going to jiggle vertical.
See if he'll turn.
It's the old perch jiggle.
Oh, he's a fish in. Oh, yeah, look at that one down there. Let's zoom in on that one, guys. He probably won't take, but it's nice to see it. Absolutely. Yeah, move along a little bit. Not looking.
Not happy with that, no. This ripple is horrible, this wind.
You just can't see what's going on. That's a nice fish.
Yeah, that's the one.
Summer conditions and clear water often create weed or algal blooms. Now, they can make for impossible casting conditions, or they can make for somewhere to hold insects. If you fish near the edge of these weed beds or any of that surface weed, it's a good place to look for trout because they're feeding on those same insects.
Well, here's a totally awesome tip. When you're fishing in the margins and you've got the sort of reeds and big grass, rather than push through with your hands, just use your rod tip, gently push it down and push the reeds to the side and just check those margins right down in front of your face. So a lot of the time the bigger trout tend to sit right where you can't see them.
A good way to keep tight to a trout is to strip that line in manually, but make sure you get all the slack off the floor where it can snag in any pieces of grass, sticks, brambles, and then when the fish powers away, like this one is now, that loose line on your floor, you know, that could snag, suddenly come up tight and you snap the fish off or pull the hook out. You can also, if you're moving around trying to get different angles on a fish like this, if that loose line is all down over the floor, there's a good chance, especially for beginners, that you're going to stand on it, and that standing on it creates the same effect. You could suddenly come up tight and snap the fish off. Again, make sure your net is pretty close to hand, and always allow, when you've got the fish on the reel, just to release that reel and just lightly feather it, just brush it to let that fish take line under pressure. With luck, you should be able to catch it.
Scales with our lumps.
What do you reckon yours is?
Oh, because 7 pounds 12 that fish there.
It's a big fish, 7 12. So it's a good big fat one.
Oh, the cheese, mine.
No, it's over 8 and a half, about 8 9.
That is big.
And pound 9 ounces.
That was a hard earned fish.
I reckon this is four and a half maybe.
Yeah,
well, four and a half probably.
That'll still give us our average of more than 5 pounds.
£5 on the dot.
So we've achieved our target for the moment, but it's lunch break time, and we've got to go and get some grub, load up, regroup, and I think we've got to go down small flies. Another tip, guys, you could be walking along like this, you come to a gap, suddenly you see fish, the fish sees you. You have to freeze, okay? I'm gonna come this side of the camera. So you're walking on, just freeze. Don't do all this arm waving and stripping line off, because they're gonna see that and spook, especially if they're down there. Just freeze, drop the fly, and as you drop it, just roll your wrist like this, look, bang. You keep all your arm movements to a minimum, and you just work the fly on the rod top. And that's the only way you're going to get these fish. When they see you, you're in trouble. So try and keep your movements just to a minimum.
With that white cloud and the fact that the light and the wind were up and down like a yo-yo, we just had to take every advantage we could of looking for individual fish, which were tough. However, Mike persevered. And yes sirree, he suddenly gets a hookup.
Guys, here's another totally awesome tip. You can sometimes catch your trout with elevation. By elevation, you've got these clumps of grass. Now, if I use these, just test them out first. These are normally like a sort of pampas grass and give me best part of 2.5 feet. Whack-a-doo, I can see absolutely loads. I'm looking down like a lord on all that he surveys, and there is a trout. And I can just from here roll cast it out, and he looks at it with total derision. But you can see, by being up high, I can look right down, cut through that surface glare, And then obviously I can't cast a long line here because it will obviously go in the grass, all my loose line like this. But I've got enough, just check my back cast, fine. I can get out a bit, and that just gives me enough height there. I can see the trout, and he's turned. Oh, wouldn't it be nice to hook him on camera? There he goes.
With Mike casting away down on the centre lake, I decided to move back up to where I thought the action was. Very often if you catch one trout, there's going to be others in the same area, and so it proved for me. And while I was battling this rainbow, Mike was just down the other end. He'd actually got into one of his favourite species, these ones. Yeah, he's gone totally over the edge. He's going for perch, can you believe? Just goes to show you, you can't ever know what you're going to catch when you go fishing. Back it goes. Meanwhile, back at the farm, the superhero was battling. Yes, his trout was still going. Well, there you go. I hope you got some tips there on stalking, how to individually target big fish. It's great fun. Get out there, give it a go, and you can catch possibly your biggest trout using this method.